Hi, I'm Jeff from Missouri Wind and Solar, and I'm going to show you how to hook up an Outback rib tie inverter. This is a 24 volt job to 1600 watts worth of solar panels. Here's my solar panel array, and just to give you an idea how big it is, these are 100 watt solar panels, a total of 1600 watts. And it's December, and they're iced over. We just had an ice storm, and it's cold as hell out here. This is our storefront in Seymour, Missouri. Two black boxes on both sides of the solar panels are solar hot air heaters. Here we are. I'm out in the shop, and this is where I decided I'm going to place it. There's my battery bank down here. And this is the Outback inverter, and this is the Outback charge controller, and this is what it'll look like after the cover's on. It's a pretty nice unit. So we went ahead and just kind of mounted this already, and I'll show you how to start running this. Okay, first here's our disconnect box. These two leads here are the solar panels coming in. And they're going into this little disconnect box. It's pretty simple. And these two leads are going to go over to the charge controller. So I'll get them hooked up. Okay, we're done wiring up the system. That is our disconnect box. And the two leads coming out of it. We've installed our inline fuse. Follow the wire around. This is very simple. Okay, here's my battery bank. I'm using a 24 volt system, and the wiring job's pretty nice. Anyway, these two banks are hooked in series. There's two banks of 24 volts. That's what it equals. And I'll show you how it hooks up to the inverter. Oh, there's one more thing. As you'll notice, I have a space between all of the batteries. And this space is so these batteries can stay cool in the summertime, so they don't overheat. They'll last a lot longer if you leave a gap in between all of the batteries. Okay, these two leads here come from the, these two leads here go over to the disconnect box. They come into the controller real easy. The terminals are marked on the inside. This is your power input. These two here go out to the battery bank. These are your battery cables. Now these two leads here go down to the battery bank. They go through a circuit breaker. Alright, these two cables here, you follow them down, go through a circuit breaker, and here's the negative, and then the positive at this end of the bank. This is the most efficient way to wire up a battery bank, 24 volts. So, that's just about it. Besides putting a ground wire from the Outback from here, you got to run a ground up to here, and then back over to a ground stake. This controller has MPPT tracking in it, and what that means is that it can increase the output of your solar panel, say like 30%, and it's 80 amp, it's fully digital, it'll tell you the exact battery voltage at the peak, it'll tell you the battery voltage at the low, it'll tell you the kilowatt hours you produced, the kilowatt hours that you've used. It'll tell you just about everything you want to know, and you can hook this thing up to your computer and run it from a remote location. But what this system is here is this is a basic system. Okay, Now next what we need to do is install the battery temperature sensor. And that's what this is. And this part here is going to stick down on your batteries. And what this does is monitor your battery temperature. It'll change the way it charges. If the batteries get too hot, it'll speed up or slow down. If they're too cold, it'll speed up charging. But anyway, that's what the temperature sensor switch is for. And it's pretty simple. Simply plug it in there. And you're good to go. You take this end, peel the plastic off, stick them on the back. There you go. And now you stick this down on the top of your batteries. There you go. And just stick it on top of the battery bank just like that. Well, that's pretty much it. This is how it looks with the cover on it. That looks pretty sharp. Very heavy system, all made in the USA too, by the way, Outback is. About the last thing to do is connect your ground wires up. There's a ground that goes from the chassis of the inverter charger up to the charge controller. And then it goes on out to a copper ground stake, an earth ground. And this is an inverter charger. When your batteries get low, it'll automatically switch over and charge your batteries back up. Last thing there is to do, of course I'm not going to show you how to do this, but you'll, now to wire this into the fuse box, you need a double pole, you need a 220 amp circuit breaker like this, and the book calls for 60 amps. Just pop this in the circuit breaker box, a couple of wires in here, you're all done. Flip the switch and you're good to go. All of the battery diagrams for hooking up 12, 24, 48 volt banks, that is all in the book from Outback, and pretty much the wire sizes, everything you need is in the book. So this is a basic system, and by the way, this puts out, one inverter puts out 120 volts AC. To get 220 volts, you have to have two of these Outbacks to feed 220 volts into your house. Otherwise, this is going to feed one side of your panel 120 volts. So, this system isn't just good for solar panels, it's also good for wind turbines. So, if you're ready to get free electricity from the sun or wind and feed back into the grid, this is the nicest system that I've seen. The most heavy duty, and the great thing is 100% made here in America. The battery bank that you see here on the floor is plenty of battery to run my home. I'm Jeff from Missouri Wind and Solar again, and I'm going to teach you in my next video how to cut your electric bill 30 to 50%. And I'm going to take everything that I've learned over the last 30 years. I was in the appliance repair refrigeration for about 25 years, and I know just about every appliance there is on the market, and I've serviced and worked on them, so I've got quite a background in it. And I got into solar energy back in the 70s before anybody really actually knew about it. So I'm going to give all of the tips and everything that I've learned, and several people have done what I've told them to do, and they have cut their bill 30%. I mean, some people have even cut their bill in half. I had a customer call me the other day, and he told me, he says, he done everything that I suggested for him to do, and he actually cut his bill in half. And I says, well, I'm kind of surprised, but he did it, and it worked, and it's absolutely free. There will be no scams. I'm not going to try to sell anything. Pretty much everything that you're going to get, you're going to get from the hardware store, or it's just going to be absolutely free. It's just something that I want to give back to all of the customers that have helped us build our business to what it is today. We're one of the biggest, well, I think we are the biggest micro wind turbine manufacturer in the Midwest. And thank you for watching. We're a real store. We have real employees. We're located on Highway 60, 30 miles east of Springfield, Missouri.
and we're usually here 6 days a week. The address is 332 Cobblestone Drive, Seymour, Missouri, 65746. And the phone number is 417-935-2260. And a lot of people come here from all over the nation, usually visiting Branson, and they make us a stop on their way. As far as I know, we were the first, and I think just about the only, do-it-yourself wind and solar store for the working guy. So we are a real store. We don't hide behind a website somewhere, and we're a mysterious person with some sort of eBay username. We are a real store. The door is open. You can come in, bring whatever you bought back. If you're not happy with it, you can talk right to me, and I'll take care of it. You won't have to do it over email and do it with some mysterious people in California. So we get a lot of ribbon and a lot of knocking from some of the people out in California, some of the other dealers, but you never see the other dealers. They don't have a store. They're strictly internet, and we do. If you have a problem with us, you can come back to my store and take it up with me, Jeff Harmon.